The Ryujin sword certainly had a test of its own today. Before we attack the armor, we test cut against a dry bamboo mat, one of the toughest things to cut cleanly, and it went through like butter. And after battering the armor mercilessly, I fully expected it to be blunted. A lot of chips, damage, and possible bending. But the sword itself survived perfectly. It is straight with a few minor chips that could be polished out. But can it still cut? Well, we found out. We cut again, some dry bamboo matting, and it went through with ease.
Ryujin swords have proven to be swords of quality.
that's how they got the idea to put the aloe in the yogurt.
Huh.
All the benefits of aloe in a Japanese-style yogurt. A love. Aloe meets yogurt.
Hello, Jason Order here. Today I'm starting my testing and review to destruction of a new katana from Ryujin Katanas. This is their first katana that they've actually released in 5160 spring steel. My job will be to test the edge, see how it performs, push it to its limits and past its limits to see exactly how much abuse this katana can take. I will start with cutting on plastic jugs, traditional mats, wood, metal, and eventually to concrete blocks and maybe granite. We'll see exactly how much abuse this new katana can take. My impression so far, it's very nice out of the box. Everything seems well put together. Everything seems nice and tight, snug. It's got great balance. It weighs about 2.4 pounds. So stay tuned as I test this, and I will have final thoughts at the end of the actual review and testing. Thank you. See, it's pretty sharp. Another cutting test to see how it performs on 4 jugs of fluid. So, here we go. You can see, very sharp edge. As you can see, it cuts very well. I will continue my testing. Hello, continuing my test and destructive test on this sword to see how it performs by cutting into a trash can and stabbing to see how the chip performs. Here we go. As you can see, that kind of impact on a metal pole against a katana is not a good idea. Of course, any abuse on a sword like this will cause massive edge damage, especially to an edge that is this fine. The fittings are all still tight, so I will continue my destructive test to see exactly how much more the sword can take. Katana, that is. Now, this is a piece of granite, so it shouldn't hold up to this. This is pretty tough stone. This can be dangerous, so please don't try this at home without safety gear. I wouldn't even try it. I'd test this so you don't have to. So here we go. Well, there you have it. After beating this continuously on a piece of granite, and it actually broke off several pieces, it did break, which any sword would do in those under those harsh, abusive conditions. It held up very well for our katana. I like the 5160 spring steel. It's pretty tough. Fittings are still pretty tight. It's coming a little bit loose right here, but overall, it's a very tough katana. And I will finish up my review and submit this to theswordbuyersguide.com. And thank you very much for your time.
Hello, Jason Witter here with my final thoughts on Ryujin's new 5160 spring steel line of katanas that they're coming out with. This sword was sent to me to actually test and review and push it to the limits to see exactly how much abuse it could take. I will say that it does come with a very fine blade, with a very fine factory edge. It held up very well to cutting jugs and traditional mats. The fittings were very tight and it had great balance. However, when I moved up to hitting it against a solid steel pole, or metal pole that is, it did take actual edge damage here. Of course, any blade that's this fine or has this sharp of an edge would take that kind of damage. But I did strike the pole many times with a lot of force and it held up well and didn't break. However, when I moved up to striking the katana against actual granite countertop pieces, that's when it actually broke. I struck the katana many times with many hard blows before it actually broke. What that tells me is that this is very well heat treated. I do know swords. I forge swords myself, and I have tested hundreds of swords. And this one actually held up very well. The fittings did come loose at the very end. But overall, for the quality of the sword and the abuse that I gave it, it held up better than I thought it actually would. And in my mind, this is a great katana for the money. So if you're interested in getting one of Ryujin's new 5160 spring steel katanas, they're going to be available at theswordbuyersguide.com. Thank you very much, Richard.